So welcome everyone to this lesson. In this lesson, I'm going to show you what are the high level steps which we are going to follow in order to create a successful automation using Telegram bot. So first thing is we need to have Telegram account, and using that we are going to interact with Telegram bot father, and which is going to give us a bot and also going to give us a token which is like a password for that bot. And then we are going to make use of Telegram APIs. All these APIs are prepared for different purposes. So for example, there is a separate API which we are going to use when we want to send a message. There is a separate API we are going to use when we want to send photo or videos and so on. And then all of these interaction which we require to make with APIs, we are going to do that using a program, and we are going to create all these programs in Python, which is one of the easiest language to learn. And then once everything is ready, we are going to do the processing. Now to process all of this, you can use any of the hosting platforms which is provided on cloud, and you need to do it in order to make sure your code runs 24/7. So hope it gave you some high level overview on how your process is going to look like and how you are going to do the complete automation. So in our upcoming lessons, we are going to learn each of these steps in more detail. Welcome to this lesson. In this lesson, I'm going to show you what are the steps required in order to create a bot. So first of all, in Telegram, we need to search for bot father. Bot father is again one bot which Telegram has created in order to do automation of all this bot creation. So we are going to search for bot father, and then we are going to start a conversation with bot father. And first thing which we need to write is slash new bot. Now slash new bot is a new command which tells bot father that we want to create our own bot. Then bot is going to respond with that, please tell me what is the name which you want to give to your bot. So then you can give any name. So in this example, you can see I have given just another bot. This is a name which is going to be given to your bot, and then it is going to ask you what is the username which you want to give to your bot. You need to make sure that username ends with underscore bot, and also username needs to be unique. So if you are going to give a username which has already been taken by any other person, in that case you will not be able to use that username. So your Telegram is going to notify you that this user is not available, so you need to give any other username which is available. And then Telegram is going to send you the token which I have hidden in this section, which you can see. And after that, one more thing which you need to do is you need to write one more command, which is slash set privacy. What it is going to do is it is going to make sure that your bot is able to read all the messages. So once you do that, you need to select which bot you want to perform this action, and you can select whatever your bot name is. If you have only one bot, in that case you may not be able to see this option, because bot father already knows that you have only one bot, and then it is going to set the privacy for that bot. So you need to make sure that you change the privacy of the bot from enabled to disabled, and once you do that, you are going to get a success notification message that the privacy has now been disabled, and then we are going to proceed ahead with the interacting with bot using bot APIs. So in next session, I'm going to show you how to create a Telegram bot using bot father, and then we are going to move on and trying to create a program to interact with bot father. So in my previous lesson, I talked about API. In this lesson, I'm going to explain you in an easy language what is an API. So an API is basically an application programming interface, and consider it like your AC remote. So what AC remote is actually an interface to interact with your air conditioner, and AC remote can handle different commands such as increasing the temperature or decreasing the temperature. So this is an interface. Now what is the functionality of this interface is, you know, performing different functions, and all the details or complex part which is written in order to achieve these functionalities, all of these are hidden behind the scene. Okay, so that is what application programming interface does. It hides all the complexities and gives you an easy interface to interact. And when it comes to software languages, we have REST APIs, and how REST APIs function is that we interact with REST API using HTTP methods such as GET, POST, PUT or DELETE, and there are several other methods as well, and we are going to call those HTTP methods, and then that methods interact with servers, which actually does all the work, and it has all the complexities, and then it processes, it replies back, which we can see in our client. Okay, now when we are interacting with Telegram, we are going to use Telegram APIs a lot, and the APIs which we are going to use are bot APIs, and all of these APIs are going to be used over HTTP protocol. So any of these API you can just copy and paste it on your browser as well, and then it is going to run as well. But obviously we want to use these APIs programmatically, that is why we are going to run it using Python. I hope in this lesson I was able to explain in very layman term what an API is and what is an interface and how we are going to interact with bot father. So let me tell you the software which we are going to use throughout this course. First thing is Telegram desktop. So many of you already have Telegram on your mobile application, which is completely fine. But in this course, I'm going to use Telegram desktop version in order to make it easier for you guys to see what I'm going through. Now, in order to download Telegram desktop software, you can go to desktop.telegram.org, and then whatever your operating system is, you can download the software for that. And installing software is very easy. You just have to double click on the software and then software is going to get launched. Once you start the Telegram interface, then it is going to be looking something like this. As you can see, this is how Telegram looks like when I'm running it on the desktop version. So apart from this, we are also going to use Google Colab. So if you don't know about Google Colab, you just need to understand that Google Colab is an application which is provided by Google, and you can access it by going to research.google.com. So for example, either you can just Google Google Colab, and then you are going to see this link and just right click on this, open it in a new tab. And then it is going to ask you to sign in by using your Google account. So you have not signed in, it is probably going to give you an option of sign in. And if you have already signed in, then it is just going to show you something like this. Now here you can just click on new notebook. And once you click on new notebook, what it is going to do is it is going to open an interface in which you are going to code using Python program. So you can see we don't really need to install any software on our machine in order to learn Python programming and start interacting with Telegram bot APIs. So throughout this course, I'm going to use it, and also towards the later end of the course, I'm going to show you how you can install Jupyter Notebook on your own computer in order to avoid using colab.research.google.com. But I personally use colab.research.google.com a lot because it provides you free GPU. So whatever code you run actually runs on Google server, so you don't really need to bother about your server being very high performance server or your computer being very high performance computer. Okay, so just for a sample, I'm going to write a sample Python code here. And you can see this is a sample Python code where we are just printing welcome message, and then this is a play icon. So I'm going to click here, and then it is going to run this code, and it is going to execute and process and going to show us whatever the outcome of this execution. So when it runs for the first time, it is a little slower because a Google Collaboratory is setting up environment for you. Here you go, you can see that we have already got the output, which is welcome. And also here you can see RAM and disk. So this is the RAM and disk which is allocated especially to your account and to your Google Colab account, which is one completely allocated to you and you can make use of. So that's it in this session. From next session, we are going to create Telegram bot. Hey everyone, I hope all of you are doing great. In today's lesson, we are going to learn about creating Telegram bot. Now what you see on the left hand side is the documentation which talks about what is the capability of bots. So if quickly if you want to see, you can see that bot is able to send customer notification and news. Bot can also integrate with other services such as Gmail bot, GIF, IMDb bot and so on. Okay, you can even connect to YouTube bot. And then bot can also accept payments from Telegram user. Bot can also do create custom tools. Okay, bot can create custom tools. Bot can build single and multiplayer games. Bot can build social services. So there are so many things which bot can do. And also if you scroll down to the documentation, you can see that there are some sample has been given of the bot which has been created, and you can get inspiration from those bots. Okay, so now let's move on and start creating our own bot. First thing which you need to do is you need to go to your mobile if you're using Telegram on mobile, and in the search you need to search for bot father. So once you search for bot father, you can see botfather interface, and then you need to write slash, and once you write slash, you will see it is going to show you list of all the commands which are available. So when you are interacting with bot, anything which starts with slash is treated as a command. So here we are going to write slash new bot. Either you can write slash new bot or you can select slash new bot, and in that case it is going to trigger bot father that we want to create a new bot. Now if you see, it is asking give the name to a bot. Okay, so we are going to call this bot. I'm going to call this bot Hello World bot, and then it is going to ask you what is the username which you want to give to this bot. So I'm going to give it a Hello World bot. Let's see if that username is available. Okay, as we can see, this username is already been taken, so we need to try something else. So let's give some different name. So I have changed my bot's name to hello_world_01_bot. You need to make sure that the name ends with underscore bot. Hit enter. Now we can see this bot is available. So it has created a bot, and also it is giving us token to this bot. Now you make sure you never share this token with anyone, otherwise anyone will be able to take control of your bot. Now just in case you have shared the token with anyone by mistake, or you think somehow your token is compromised, in that case you should change token immediately. Now in order to change token again, you can start slash, and then just scroll down, we should be able to see slash token. So click on slash token, and then it is going to ask you for which bot you want to change the token. Now you see I have already so many bots created, that is the reason I'm getting this option. If you have just one bot created, you may not get this option as well. So here I'm going to select hello underscore world bot, which we have just created, and then it has just changed the access token again. Now throughout this tutorial I'm going to use this token, and once the tutorial is completed, after that I'm going to create a new token so you guys are not able to access my bot. And after this, as I told you, we also need to set the privacy to disabled. So I'm going to click on slash again, and then we are going to set it. I'm just going to scroll down and check for set privacy, and then I'm going to select the bot for which I want to make these changes. So it is a Hello World 01 bot. And then I want to change the privacy to disable. Okay, so that's it. Congratulations, you have created a bot and you have also set the privacy to disable. Now in next session, we are going to see how to add this bot in any group and then how to start reading messages from that group. Hey everyone, welcome to this lesson. In this lesson, we are going to create a group and then we are going to add our bot in that group. And then we are going to use bot APIs and going to see whether our bot is able to read any messages which is being sent in that group. So first I'm going to create a new group and I'm going to call that group. Let's think a good name for our group. Let's call it Hello World Training. Now it is asking who are the members which I want to add in this group. So I'm going to add the bot which we have created. So remember, our bot name is Hello World underscore 01 underscore bot. So it is going to find our bot, and then you can select that bot, click on create. And then our group is ready. So our group is called Hello World Training and our bot name is Hello underscore World underscore 01 underscore bot. Okay, so you can see right now we have already added our bot in the group. So if I click here on the title, you can see in the group info, we can see that this bot has already been added. And also if you are on desktop version, in that case, you can click on view group info and then you should be able to see group information as well. And otherwise you can also click here. So once you click on this, it is going to open group info on the right hand side, which is going to give you information about all the members which are there in that group. So now since we have our bot here in the group, now let's see whether our bot is able to read any message which is being sent here or not. Okay, so right now I'm not going to write any message. First thing, let's try to understand the API which is required in order to see the messages with the bot. Now here on the right hand side, you can see I have gone to collab.research.google.com and here I'm going to click on new notebook in order to create a new notebook, and then we will start programming and we will start seeing how to interact with this bot and how to read all the messages which has come from this bot. So first thing which we will do is let's give a name to this notebook and then we will start code. So this notebook I'm gonna call bot demo training, and throughout the course we are going to use the same notebook. So whatever code I'm going to add, it is going to be added in this notebook. Now we will start making use of bot APIs. So as I told you, in order to interact with a bot, we are going to use APIs, which is going to be basically giving us an interface to easily interact with bot, and all the heavy work or complex work is actually going to be done by bot APIs under the hood. So here you can see I'm going to use our first API, which is going to be called api.telegram.org/bot, and then we need to give the token ID of the bot. So in this case, as you remember, our token ID is already stored there on botfather. So I'm going to go to botfather, and then here on the botfather, if you remember, I guess you don't remember because this is such a long API key, I'm going to copy this key and then I'm going to paste it here. Okay, so make sure you have this URL until here, and then you paste the complete token, whatever you have got from botfather, and then we are going to write slash, and then we are going to write get updates. Okay, so this is the API which we are going to use in order to get update from Telegram bot. Now on the left hand side, again I'm going to search for the group which we have created. So our group name is Hello World, and let me also send first message to this group. So I'm gonna write hi, and now I'm going to, so now as I told you in API introduction video, so these APIs can be called using HTTP method. So rather than calling this API here programmatically, first I'm going to copy this, and then I'm going to open a new tab here, and then I'm going to paste everything here. Okay, and then hit enter, and then let's see what is the data which we get. So ideally it is going to show us all the messages which has been received by bot. So here you can see by default it is not showing us any message. So I'm going to write here slash hi, and let's see if our bot is able to read this message. So now you can see our bot was able to read slash hi. Okay, and also this message is actually a bot command. Now One thing, if you remember, is our bot was somehow not able to read high, so we will look into that. And other thing which you can see is this is a JSON data. Okay, so if you know about JSON data, it is very good. You'll be able to easily understand everything. But basically, when we interact with Telegram API, Telegram API returns us the data in JSON format. Now, JSON format is very easy. I'm going to explain that to you in next session in little more detail. However, there is a JSON formatter which we are going to use throughout this course. So I'm going to search for JSON Prettifier by going to Google and searching for JSON Prettifier. And then you can see first we have a JSON formatter. So you can use anything. You can see there are so many options available. So probably let's go ahead and check the second option. And it is basically going to give us an interface. So here you can see on the left hand side, I need to paste the API. So whatever, if you have previously used this website, so now you can see on the left hand side, I need to give the JSON, and on the right hand side, it is going to prettify it, and then it is going to show it, us that. So here I'm going to copy everything. Let's copy all the message which we have received, and then we are going to paste it here. And now click here on Tree Viewer, and here you can see on the right hand side, it has prettified this JSON, and now we can expand this result. We can expand this. And then we can see in messages we have received, we have data, something which is called message ID from chat. And if I expand from, then I can see who is the person who has sent this message. So we can see that in this group, I'm the one who sent the message. So here we can see this is the message which is here. And I'm going to expand chat. In the chat, you can see title of the group, which is Hello World Training. So you can see this is the title of our group. And in the type also, it is telling you that this message has come from group. And if you see here, text in the text actually contains the actual message. And then if you expand entities here, we don't see anything important. So that's not what we need. So mostly all the data which we are going to see stays under messages. So under messages, we have so many important data. Okay, so that's all you needed to know. Now let's see why we didn't get message, high message which we printed here. Ideally, all the messages which we are sending in this group, we should be able to see those messages. Now let's say I'm going to send one more message, which is hello world, hit enter. And then we are going to go back here, and then we are going to refresh it, and it should be able to show us hello world. Okay, now for some reason when we wrote hi, it was not able to send us the data related to that. So sometimes when you are working on bot for the first time and you are hitting this application for the first time, there might be a couple of messages which might be missed, but after that you are not going to see any missed messages. So now you can see we wrote hello world, and hello world is also here. So if I write something else like good morning, and then if we refresh it here, you can see that there is one more data which is called good morning. Okay, so you see there is set of data which is being sent, and also you can see all the messages which we are seeing is almost in the same format. So here you can see this is the data which we have received. So if you want to, again, you want to JSON prettify it, you can again go ahead and use it. So for example, here again, if I want, I can copy it, and then I'm gonna paste it here. Or let's do one thing, let's just copy everything, and then we are going to paste it here. So I'm gonna copy everything from here, and I'm gonna paste it here on JSON prettifier. And then we are going to click on Tree Viewer, and now here you can see earlier we had result as one, now we had three result, because we have three messages here. Okay, first message was this, second was this, third was this, and the very very first message which was sent in the beginning somehow got missed, which is fine. It can happen when you are creating a new account and you are adding the user to the group and you sending the message immediately. Okay, but from now onward there should not be any message which is going to get missed. Now let's expand this zero and click on message. You can see in text we had slash hi. Now expand the first one, go to message, expand it. You can see in the text we have hello world. Expand this second one, you can see now we have good morning. Okay, so we can see all the messages which we are sending here. We are able to see all those messages by using this API, which is which we called just by writing this complete API call on the browser address bar. Okay, so this is the API which we called, and remember, as of now we have not used Python programming at all. All we did is we just called this API directly, pasted here on this address bar, which actually made an HTTP GET call, and we were able to see all the data which was being sent in this group. Now we are going to see, in next session we are going to see how we can interact with the same bot API using a program. So welcome to this lesson. In this lesson we are going to write a small Python program and we are going to use BotFather API and we are going to see whether we are able to read the data or not. So whenever we are making HTTP calls, we are going to use a library which is called requests. So in order to import any library on Python, we can just write import and the name of the package. So in this case I'm going to write import and requests. That's all. Now we have imported package and now we are going to make a get call. So we are going to write requests.get and then we need to specify the URL under this parenthesis, and also we need to make sure that this URL is in double quotes. So that's all. Now this is going to give us exactly the same output which we have received when we used HTTP get using this method. Okay, when we just copy pasted all this API on the browser and then we hit enter, we got all this data. So this is exactly the same data we should be able to get by running this. Now we are getting the data, but we are not saving this data anywhere. So I'm going to create a variable which is called response. So I'm going to call it RISP for short. And then we are going to read it or going to print it by saying print response.txt. That's it. Now click on this play icon. It should be able to read this data and it should be able to display it here. Now you can see here on the screen when I executed this program, this is the output which I have received. So here again in this output you can see we have three lines of messages. So first line is all about the first method or first actually command which I wrote, which was slash hi, and then second piece of text which we written was hello world, and the third one which we wrote was good morning. Now notice one thing, all the data which you see here is again in JSON format. So if I copy and paste everything here, so for example I'm just gonna copy everything and gonna paste everything here on JSON viewer. So I'm gonna remove it, I'm gonna paste it again. So you see the message is exactly the same, and then if I click on tree viewer, we are going to see everything as we saw previously. So this is the use of, you know, this is the power of Python. With very few lines of code, you are able to do a lot of things. So for example, here you can see just with three lines of code, we were able to call a get HTTP API and we are able to see the data. So that's all in this lesson. See you again in the next lesson. Hey everyone, welcome to this lesson. So until now I have shown you how we can read data using directly from HTTP get API method by directly writing the API here on the address bar of the browser. And I also shown you how we can run the same program by using Python and then how we can get the same data. Now in this lesson what we want to achieve is we want to read only the messages which we have not read. So for example, let's say you are part of a group or your bot is basically part of a group where thousands of messages are being sent. So in that case, whenever you run this API, in that case you are going to get list of all the messages again and again. So for example, let's say if I run this API again and I execute it again, you can see I have got all the data. So what if we want to tell Telegram bot that I have already read this data, I don't want to see this data again. So how we can do that thing? So the answer is always Telegram bot documentation. So we can go to Telegram API documentation and then we can see that in get updates we also have something called parameters. So parameters are basically additional data which you can send when you are calling API. So here it is saying along with get updates we can also pass a parameter which is called offset, and in offset we can pass update ID. So whichever update ID which we pass, it means we are going to read data only from that update ID or greater. So this is going to make sure that it is not going to send us all the old data. Okay, so what I mean is, so for example if you come here you can see all the messages always begin with update ID. So for example in this case also you can see we have an update ID, and then similarly again if you move on to next message then again we have update ID and so on. And similarly if you go here in JSON and if you see all these messages, so for example you can see we have three entities, and let me first collapse everything. Now you can see if I expand first message, we can see we have an update ID here, then we have an update ID here as well, and so on. Okay, so basically all the messages are always having an update ID. Now let's say in this case I want to tell to Telegram that okay, I have already read all the messages, update messages which were older than this update ID, okay, and now I'm only interested in the message which is either equal to or greater than this update ID. So how do we do that? So for that what we need to do is we need to send additional parameters to this API, and in order to send any additional parameter we need to write question mark, and then we need to write name of the parameter for which we want to send data to. So here we want to send data to offset, so we are going to write offset, and then we are going to say offset equal to, and I'm going to give this update ID. Okay, so here I'm gonna paste this update ID, and then I'm going to run it again. So what will happen is, once I run it, you'll be able to see that we are going to get only data from this update ID onwards. Okay, we are not going to get previous data. So message ID 6 and 7 we are not able to get. Okay, I'm just gonna run it again and let's see how what happens this time. So you can see this time what has happened is, Telegram API has only given us data for message ID 8. Okay, so previous message IDs we have not received. And if you see here, we have written update ID should be this or greater, which means if you just move again here towards the left, you can see in update ID we have this update ID which is equal to this. So if I write any new message, I'll be able to receive that new message. So for example, I'm just gonna change this screen, and on the right side let me also use Telegram. I'm just gonna keep it here. So now let's say I'm going to write some new message. I'm gonna say, hey, this is a new message, and then I'm going to run it again. So in that case, you will see we will be able to read new message. So here you can see we have got the new message, which is called, hey, this is a new message. Now I'm going to write one more message. I'm gonna call it, this is one more message. Okay, and then we are going to refresh it again, and then you can see now we are able to see new message as well. Okay, so now let's say if I have already read data until this is one more message, so I'm gonna give this update ID. So for example, in this case, this is the latest update ID. I'm going to copy it, and then actually I just want to copy this message, and then I'm going to update this update ID here. So now you can see we are giving this update ID, which means all the latest message we are saying we have already read. So I'm just going to execute it, and let's see what happens this time. So it's only going to give us last update ID data. Okay, now if I don't want this data as well, then I can just increase this offset ID by 1. So for example, rather than 88, I can make it 89, and in this case, if I execute it, it is just going to give me all the messages where update ID is equal to 89 or above. Okay, so I'm going to write some new message. So for example, let's write 1, enter 2, enter 3, and then we are going to run it, and we should be able to see 3 new messages, 1, 2, and 3. So here you can see we have received new updates, message ID are 11, 12, and 13, and then on the right side you can see in the text we have 1, we have 2, and we have 3. So that is how you can control the messages which you want to read by using offset ID. So that's all in this lesson. See you again in the next lesson. Hey everyone, I hope all of you are doing great. So in today's lesson, I'm going to show you what is the better way of writing the same code. Now this code looks perfectly fine when you are working with very small code. Okay, so as of now this looks perfectly okay, it is neat and clean, but trust me, it is going to get very ugly if you need to write the complete code and you need to write maybe probably hundreds of lines of code. So what we need to do is, rather than using this, what we are going to do is we are going to arrange it in a better way. So going forward, we are going to follow that example. So if you want to add more cells in this, you can just click on plus code, and what is going to happen is, now you can see there is a new cell which has come. So first of all, I'm just going to copy paste everything, and then we are going to make changes here. So now you can see in our API we have two parts. We have a part which is going to be always static. So here you can see until here it is always static. This is the API, and then we have some parameter data which we are going to pass to this API. Okay, so rather than using this, what we can do is we are going to break it, and we are going to call it a base URL. So base URL is going to be the URL which is not going to change. So for example, in this case, what we are going to do is, until here I'm going to cut it, and I'm going to paste it here. Again, we need to make sure whatever the string we enter, we need to enter in double quotes. So it is going to be base URL. And now in order to pass all the parameters, I'm going to use parameters. And I'm going to say parameters is equal to, and then we need to use dictionary. So if you know about Python dictionary, very good. If you don't know, you don't need to bother. Just you need to make sure you use curly braces, and then you need to set whatever the data you want to pass. So for example, as we saw in this Telegram get updates, we want to pass this parameter which is offset. So we need to write offset here. Again, it needs to be in double quotes, and then we need to use colon, and then we need to write the data which we want to write. So for example, in this case, again, I'm need to use double quotes, and then we wanted to pass this offset ID. So I'm gonna cut it and gonna paste it here. So now this piece of line, these two piece of line is exactly the same as writing this line. Okay, even though we have increased the number of lines, but this data is going to be more cleaner, and especially when our code is going to increase, you will be noticing that this is going to give you more visibility and going to make your code clearer. You'll be able to understand your code better, and then eventually it is going to help you when you want to troubleshoot the code or you want to fix the code when you face any issues. Now once we make a syntax like this, we need to make some changes here. So now what we need to do is in request.get I need to call base URL. So remember, base URL is exactly this URL, and then we are saying, we are passing the data which is here in this parameter. So I'm saying data is equal to parameters, and that's it. And then print is going to be exactly the same. Now I'm going to execute it, and this should give us exactly the same data which we saw here. Okay, so you can see both in both the scenarios we have got exactly the same data. Now I'm going to show you one more parameter which we can pass to get updates. So here you can see in get updates we have limit. So what limits does it? It tells you how many messages you want to read. So for example, in this case you can see we are able to read 3 messages. But what if we just want to read only one message? Okay, so in that case we can use limit. So for example, in this case I'm just gonna write comma, then I'm going to write limit, and then again we need to use colon, then we need to write number of messages which we want to read. So I'm gonna say 1, and then I'm going to run this code again, and now you'll be noticing we are going to read only one message. Okay, so now what BotFather does is, or this API does it, is knows that we want to read the data, okay, and we want to read the data where offset ID is equal to or more than this, then it says okay, limit is equal to 1, so which means I can only send one record of data. Now if I change this limit to 2, for example, in that case we are going to see 2 pieces of data. So here I'm going to execute it. Now you can see we have received 2 messages, and if I change it to 3, we can see we are going to see 3 messages. Okay, now limit may not make more sense right now because we are having only 3 messages. Now what if you are part of the groups where you see 1000 of messages, okay, and at any point of time you want your program to handle only 100 messages, or in increment of 100 messages you want your program to read all the messages. So you don't want to read 1000 messages in one shot because probably your code will not be able to handle those functionality or the processing. So you can limit the number of messages which you want to read. Now if the same thing which you had to do here, what you can do is you can again use ampersand. So if you want to pass multiple parameters here, you need to separate one parameter to another by using ampersand. So here we are using ampersand sign, then I'm saying limit, and here I'm saying equal to, let's make it 1, and then we are going to run this code. Okay, now you see everything is, you know, this code probably right now also it might be looking better to you because again we are working on small code. Now just imagine if I had to pass hundreds of parameters or probably 20 of parameters or even 5 parameters, this string is gonna look very longer, okay, longer and longer. And then if you want to troubleshoot anything, it's gonna give you lots and lots of problem. And again, in our upcoming session, this code structure is going to make a lot more sense. So from now onwards, we are just going to use this structure whenever we are going to call an API. So that's it in this lesson. See you again in the next lesson. Hey everyone, I hope all of you are doing great. So far we have already learned about how to read all the message which is being sent in a group. Now we are going to learn how to send a message to any group. Now first thing what I will do is I'm gonna remove this cell so we don't have any confusion, and we are just going to have this syntax here. Okay, now other API which we need to call is, we need to call send message API. So here I'm gonna write send message, and now you can see this is the API which we need to use. And how to use this API, I'm just gonna show it to you. It's very simple. First, let's copy all the code here, and I'm gonna insert one more cell, and I'm gonna paste this cell here. Now, one more thing about Google Colab, which I like a lot, is that you can also use text. So for example, here, what we can do is, here I can use a text, and here we can write any comment about this, you know, cell. So for example, here, probably I can write that. So I'm gonna change it to title, and that's it. So now you can see that this example is reading data from groups, and which is perfectly fine. This makes sense. And inside this we have other codes, so which is fine. Now what we are going to do is I'm going to add one more text here so we increase the readability, and let's call it, I'm going to add new section and I'm going to call it send message. Okay, so this is fine and that's it. Now we can move on to this cell. Now one thing, if you want to change the name to new section, you can give it some other name. For example, here we can give other name like sending messages. Now this is completely okay. If you don't want to do all this, this is fine, you can just leave it. This is just something which is going to make more sense when you have so many pieces of code written and you want to review all the code. Okay, so if you write your code more clearly, you give the comments, it's gonna be very easier for you to just revisit the code and going to use it again if you just want to do a quick revision in the future. So here what we are going to do is we are going to change this API based on whatever is required for this send message. So one thing we can see here is we need to use send message endpoint. So here you can see we had used get updates. Here we are going to make changes and we are going to write send message here. Okay, now let's read in the documentation. So what it says is that if you want to send a message, you need to know chat ID and then you need to write text. Okay, and then all other things are optional. So here you can see in the required column it says yes, yes. So these are mandatory. First two, which is chat ID and text, is mandatory, and remaining all are optional. So if you want to send message, you need to know chat ID. So chat ID is basically a unique group ID for any group, or if you are talking to an individual, then it is going to be a chat ID for you and that person. Okay, so again, that is going to be unique. So what is the chat ID and how to get the chat ID? So if you go back to our code and if you see our data carefully, so when we return get updates and you read this data carefully, you will see that in our data we also have chat ID, and you will notice that chat ID is always the same. The reason is that all this chat is being written in a group, and as I told you, that chat ID is unique to the group. Okay, so this is a chat ID where we want to send the data to, and if we send the data to this chat ID, it means the data is going to be sent in the Telegram group which we have, you know, which from where we have sent all this data so far. Now we are going to, the bot is actually going to send the data to that group. So what we need to do here is we are going to change this offset. We are going to make it chat ID and we are going to give this chat ID here. So here I'm going to change it. And one more thing which I just want to tell you, that all the chat ID which begins with minus or hyphen, these are the ones which belongs to groups. If you see any chat ID which doesn't have hyphen or doesn't start with hyphen or minus, then that means that chat ID is of a one-to-one interaction. Now here we have given the chat ID. Now we need to give text. So I'm going to go here and here I'm going to change limit. I'm going to call it text. And here let's write whatever message you want to write. So this is, or let's say hi from bot. Okay, so this is the message which is going to get written and everything looks okay. I think this is gonna be fine. I'm just going to open Telegram here as well so we can see. And now you can see on this side we have Telegram, on this side we have our code written, and I'm going to execute it and let's see how it looks like. So I haven't executed it yet. Now I'm gonna click here on the play icon and let's see if it works. Brilliant, you can see here we have a message coming from hello world bot. This is our bot and it is saying hi from bot. The bot has been able to send the message. And notice one more thing, that once we send the message, then once we run this API is going to return some data. Okay, so the return data is actually the message which has been sent. So the message which was sent is hello world bot, and for this message also there is an unique ID and update ID. So here you can see message ID is going to be this, and this is the ID which is actually an update ID for this. Okay, so you don't need to worry about all this as of now. We are going to look into this when we need to look into this. For now, all you need to see is that we are successfully able to send the data here or send the message here. Now one more thing which you can do is, probably now this is just a one-time message, what if we need to send a message every 1 hour, or let's say you want to send a message every 2 minutes, you want to send some jokes every 2 minutes. So let's see how we can do those things. So I'm just gonna quickly go to Google and going to search list of 10 jokes probably, and then here you can see we have some short jokes. So I'm just gonna grab some jokes, I'm gonna prepare a list, and then we are going to send the jokes over and over again probably on some period of time. Or if I don't find anything, then probably, okay, so I don't really find some CSV sort of data, so I'm just gonna copy a joke here and I'm gonna create a list. So for example, here I'm going to write jokes equal to, and here we need to use Python list. Okay, so if you know Python and if you want to write multiple elements, so you need to write it in a list. So here I'm gonna create a list, I'm going to write the joke here. So this is our first joke, then we can write comma, then we can write our second joke. So I'm just gonna write joke 2, then I'm gonna say joke 3, comma joke 4. So these are not actual jokes, but I know you guys are going to replace it with the actual jokes. So now here you can see we have jokes, and what we are gonna do is we are going to change this code little bit. So we are going to use now for loop. So if you know Python, again, it's going to be very easy. So we are saying for joke in jokes, and we are going to move all of this code towards the right. And now here in the text, I'm gonna replace it and I'm gonna change it to joke. Okay, so every time this code is going to run, it is going to send all of these jokes one by one, and between each jokes we also want to give some gaps. So for example, I want to send each joke every, let's say, 1 hour or 20 minutes or whatever time you want. So in that case, we need to use another module which is called time. So I'm gonna say import time, and here we are going to say time.sleep, and we want to sleep for, let's say, in this example I only want to sleep for 10 seconds before sending a message, and which is fine. And in your case, you can replace it to any number of seconds which you want. So I'm going to run this code again, and let's see how this code works this time. So here it is probably going in the loop and probably waiting for 10 seconds, and after 10 seconds we should be able to see our first joke, and then second joke, and then so on. So you can see we have already received a first joke, which is called I invented a new word, something like that. And then it is going to, again, it is, you can see this code is still running. Okay, it is running, and now it has sent another joke, which is here you can see joke 2, and so on. It is gonna keep on running and gonna keep on sending new jokes. So that's how you send a message, or probably send a list of messages, or send any type of message which you want. So thank you so much for watching. See you again in the next lesson. Welcome to this lesson. In this lesson, we are going to learn about how to send a photo using Telegram bot API, and we are going to send a photo here on this group. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm just going to create, or I'm gonna add one more cell, and for that we can just click here on plus code, and then if you want to reshuffle it, for example, if you want this code to be moving down, in that case you can click here on down arrow, and this code or this cell is gonna be moved down. Now I'm gonna copy this and then I'm gonna paste it here. And then what we are going to do here is, one thing is, you see here we have send message. Now if we go to Telegram API documentation, it says if you want to send a photo, you need to use send photo. So for example, I'm just going to change it, change this endpoint. I'm going to put send photo here, and let's go to documentation again. It says you need to have chat ID. So we already know about chat ID, and we don't really need to go into more detail about this. And the second thing it says is photo. So in photo, we need to give either the input file name, or we need to give any HTTP URL. So what it means is we can just give any image URL, and then Telegram is going to auto download that image and going to send over the to the group. So what we are going to do here is we are going to change this text to photo, and then here we are going to give one URL. Now notice one thing, since we have just made some changes in the code, so I'm gonna remove it for now. If you don't know about Unsplash, Unsplash is basically a free collection of images which you can use. So here I'm gonna go to Unsplash. If you want to search for an image to download, you can search for that image by typing that keyword. In this case, let's say I want to download any image related to travel. So I'm gonna go to travel, and here you can see this is the download click link. But we don't really want to download this image here on our computer. What we rather want is, I'm gonna right click here, we want to get this link. So I'm gonna say copy link address, and then we want to go to our code, and in the photo we want to paste this URL. So here you can see we have pasted the URL. Now URL is a string, so it needs to be quoted. So here I'm gonna quote this as well, so make sure it is in double quotes. So everything looks fine until now. Let's go again to the documentation and see what next. So here you see we can also give caption. So by caption, what we mean is we can send the image, and with the image there is going to be some caption written as well. Okay, so we'll be using that later on. First let's try to send this one and see if it works, and then we are going to use caption again. Now I'm going to execute it by running here. So just click here, and you can see here now in the group it has already sent the image, and you can see how fast this is. As soon as we clicked here, we already got the image here. Now I'm gonna add caption here, so you can see how it looks like. I'm just gonna write caption, and I'm going to write, here is a travel photo for you. Okay, and then we are going to run it again. So I'm just gonna run it, and this time we should be able to see the photo. Okay, so here you see I made a mistake. I had to put comma here as well. So if you want to add more key value pair, you have to separate it by comma. So I'm gonna put comma, rerun it, and this time it should be okay. So you can see this time we have received the photo again, but this time we have also received the caption, which looks like this. So here you can see this is the caption, and this is how you send the photo. Now what if I want to change this code again, and I want to create a kind of, you know, for loop, and in that for loop we want to enter multiple code. Okay, so let's see how that is going to work. So in this case, what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy paste everything here, and then now in base URL, okay, so here we don't need to make any changes. I'm going to say URLs, and in URLs we are going to create a list, and here I'm going to give list of all the URLs. Okay, so for example, let's say these are all the pictures which we can download. So I'm going to copy this URL, and then I'm going to put this URL link here, and then I'm gonna do the same for other URL. So basically what I mean is that you should be able to have a collection of all the URLs which you want to send, and then you should be able to send it. So for example, in this case, let's see, these are all the three links which I wanted to send, and just make sure this is in proper format. So you need to use double quotes and comma, and for last one you don't need to use comma, only for the first one, second one, up until the last point you need to separate by comma, but for the last value you don't need to put comma in there. Okay, so this is fine, this is the URL. Now what we want to do here is we want to replace this photo, we want to change it to URL. Okay, and here we are going to create a for loop again. So I'm gonna say for URL in URLs, and we need to move everything towards the right, and here I'm gonna say time.sleep. I want to sleep for 10 seconds before sending an image, and caption is fine. I just want to keep the same caption. This should be perfectly fine. Now we are going to run it, and let's see how everything works this time. So now it is running. It is probably gonna wait for 10 seconds before sending a photo, and then it is gonna wait for another 10 seconds. It is going to send next photo, and then it is going to send next photo again. So you can see we have already received our first photo, and it says the caption which we have written here, and this is the first photo which we have received. Now it is going to wait for another 10 seconds, and this is going to send us a next photo, and then next photo, and so on. Now if you don't want this URL to be static, you can change this, you know, this piece of code as well. So it automatically goes to Unsplash and pulls a new URL, and then it, you know, sends that URL in this code. Okay, so we can do all those sort of things, but this is how you send a photo using Telegram bot API. So thank you so much for watching this lesson. See you again in the next lesson. Hello everyone, welcome to this lesson. In this lesson we are going to learn how to send an audio file using any URL. So what I'm going to do is I'm first going to copy this code which we use to send images. So I'm going to copy it, and then I'm going to create a new code cell, and then in this code cell I'm going to paste the code which we had. And then in order to send an audio file, what we need to do is we need to change it to send audio, and then in this send audio API, what we need to call is we need to call audio, and we need to give URL of the audio. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to Bensound, which is royalty, which provides you royalty free music, and then I'm going to just download one of the, I'm going to get link of one of the audio URL. So I'm going to copy this link, and then I'm going to go here, and then I'm going to change this URL, and I'm going to give URL of an audio file. So here I have given a URL of an audio file, and then in caption again you can change it to something like, here is an audio file for you. So everything looks good here. We should be able to run it without any issue, and let me execute it and see how it works. So here you can see we have already received an audio file, and if you just want to do a quick comparison, you can see that the audio file is of 2 minutes and 26 seconds in length, and this is exactly the same file which we have received here. So that's how you can send an audio file from any URL. So that's it in this lesson. See you again in the next lesson. Hey everyone, welcome to this new lesson. In this lesson we are going to learn how to send an audio file from a local computer. So what I'm going to do is, this is a code which we used in order to send an image file from local computer. I'm going to copy it, and then I'm going to create a new code cell, and then I'm going to paste it here. And then we are going to make some changes here in order to make it send an audio file from local computer. So if you remember, I shown you that you can go to this explorer, file explorer, which is going to give you a list of all the files which you have uploaded. So here I have uploaded a file. So you can just right click here on this and click on copy path. In this case, you are going to get the path of this. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to open this file again. So I'm just going to give full path here. And then again, there is no changes required here. It is going to be exactly the same. And then here we need to change it from photo to audio. And here also from send photo, we need to change it to send audio. Now remember, it is case sensitive, so you need to write send and then A is in caption, audio, okay? And again, if you want to follow API documentation, then again, you can go to actual Telegram API documentation and you can follow the syntax from there as well. But here I'm already simplifying everything for you. So here what I'm going to say is here, I'm gonna say here is another audio file for you. And now everything looks okay, and if I run it, we should be able to receive audio file here. So I'm just gonna run it and let's see how it works. So now you can see we have received an audio file here, and also this audio file is 21 MB in size. So that's it in this lesson. See you again in the next lesson. Hey everyone, I hope all of you are doing great. In today's lesson, we are going to learn how to send any file from local computer to Telegram. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy this code and going to paste it here in this cell. And then here on the left side, what we are going to see is that we have sample data, and in the sample data I have some CSV files. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy this, I'm going to right click here and copy the path of this CSV file, and then I'm going to paste that path here. And then the changes which we need to make here is we need to change it to send document, and also here in files you can see we have audio. Now I'm going to change it to document. And that's it. If you want, you can change the caption. So in this case, I'm just gonna change it from audio. I'm gonna call it here is another document for you. And everything else actually looks pretty okay. So I'm going to run this code and let's see how it works. Let me fit it here so we can also see Telegram screen. So I'm gonna use the group which we have created. So this is the group which we have created. And now let me also close this part. So this is the code which you can see here on the left side, and this is the group which you can see here on the right side. Now I'm going to execute it, and hopefully if everything is okay, we should be able to see that we are going to get a CSV file here. So it is still executing, and now you can see we have received a CSV file. Okay, the CSV file was quite huge, so it is around 35 MB in size. So that is the reason it just took a bit second in order to send it. But if you have a smaller file, then it is going to be sent within a second. So that's it in this lesson. See you again in the next lesson. Hey everyone, welcome to this lesson. From this lesson, we are going to start making baby steps toward creating a chatbot. So in order to create a chatbot, what we need is we need to be able to read the message, and also we should be able to apply some condition to the message which we have read, and then we should be able to respond accordingly. So for example, when we see hi message in a group, we probably want to reply with hello. Okay, so you can see that we have multiple operations which is being taken. So until now, whatever operations we have performed, it was more like a one way. So we were either reading the message, or we were either sending a message, we were sending an audio file, or we were sending image file, or we were sending documentation, and so on. But until now, we have not made use of multiple functions in the or multiple features in the same program. So here we need to be able to understand that how to read the message, and also how to see whether the message meets certain criteria. So for example, if I say hi, we need to compare the message which has been sent is equal to hi, and then we should be, or basically bot should be able to say hello based on that message. So first thing what I have done here is I have sent some couple of more messages here in this group. So you can see I have sent hello from bot, I have sent hi, and then I'm just going to go to the very beginning. So this is the first program which we have created where we were reading the messages, and if I execute it, you can see we are going to see new messages here. So now you can see we have hello from bot, we have hi, and so on. Okay, so all this so we know this program we are going to use when we want to read all messages. So I'm going to copy it and I'm going to paste it here in the new cell. And also what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy this sending messages code as well, and I'm going to paste it in the end as well. Okay, now it is the same cell where I have pasted this code for reading message and then this code for sending message. So if you see, there are some common things which we can eliminate. So for example, if you see import request and time is not required, then base URL also, if you see now, if you see, if base URL until here is always going to be same, and then only the last word which is the endpoint is going to be different. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to remove it, and here also I'm going to get rid of get update, and I'm going to remove it this as well. So now our base URL is going to be this, because we know that this is always going to be static, this is not going to change. And then I'm just going to create a function. So we are going to now move move everything into functions. If you know about Python functions, you are already familiar what is the advantages of Python functions. So basically function you can create once and then you can use it multiple times. So that's the reason we should be moving our modular code into functions. So in order to create a function, we need to say def and we need to say what is the name of the function which we want to create. So for example, this function is actually to read messages. So I'm gonna call it read message, and then we need to move all this code inside this function. Okay, so that's all. Everything looks okay, pretty much okay here. And also what we are going to do is, so I'm gonna change this send message code and I'm going to make it part of a new function which is going to be called send message. And inside this again we need to move this code little bit, and I'm going to remove all these jokes. We no longer want to send any joke. Okay, so now what we have is we have two functions. We have a function which is called read message, and then we have another function which is called send message. So what read message is going to do is, read message is going to continuously read the messages from this group, and then if it finds that there is a word which is equal to hi, in that case it is going to call this message send message and it is going to reply accordingly. Okay, so what we are going to do is, let's comment this for now, and then we are going to see read messages, and we are going to see how to read only messages from this group. Okay, so as of now you have seen that in the beginning when I executed this, we got a complete JSON. Now out of this JSON, I'm not interested in complete JSON. I just want to parse only the text which is being sent here in this group. So if you see here in the JSON beautifier, what we have here is, in the JSON we have object, a complete object, and under object we have a message which is called OK is equal to true, and then we have result. Under results, then we have all the messages. So here you can see all the messages which are here. Then inside this we have message, and inside message we have text. Okay, so from here we are going to get all the text which is actually being sent. So if you know Python, again it is just Python function or Python dictionary handling which we need to know here in order to perform this. So what I'm gonna do is, I'm going to create a for loop here. So I'm gonna say for result in response, and notice here until now response is actually not in JSON format. So what I'm gonna do is, let's first convert our response to JSON by writing response.json, and now our data is going to be under data variable, and under data what we are interested in, we are interested in result. So under data we are going to get result. So we can write from data we want to get result, and for each result we want to actually run this loop. And inside the loop what we want to do is, for now I'm just going to print result, and inside result we are interested in message. As you can see here, inside result we have message which we are interested in, and inside message we are interested in text, okay, which is equal to the value of the text which is being sent here in the group. So I'm going to write message, and then I'm going to write text, and everything looks okay here. Now if I'm going to run this, we should be able to see only the text message which is being sent here. So for example, now you can see this is a function. So we have defined everything inside the function, but we are not calling this function. So first of all, I also need to make sure I'm calling this function. So I'm going to write that code here. So in order to call a function, you just call it like this. So I'm going to execute it, and this time hopefully it should be able to print the message. Now you can see it is giving us some error. So let's see what is the error which we are getting here. Okay, now notice one thing here in the API URL, what I had done is I have removed that part, okay, slash get updates part. So what we need to do is, here in the base URL we also need to write plus, and we need to write get updates, and also there should be slash. So now we are going to rerun it, and this time we should be able to see all the messages. So now you can see we have all the message which was being sent. So if I send a new message, let's say I'm gonna call it new message, and if I rerun this code, we should be able to see this new message here. So you can see we already able to see this new message. So now what I'm gonna do is, I'm rather than printing it here, what I'm gonna do is I'm going to put an if condition here. So I'm gonna say if hi in this message. Okay, so if this message contains hi, then it is going to call a different function, which is this function. It is going to call send message. Okay, so we are going to say, if in message you have hi written, in that case you should call send message, and in this case what send message is going to do is, send message is going to reply with hello. So what we need to do here is, again in the base URL we need to append base URL plus, and we need to write slash send message. So I'm just going to go on top just to make sure the API which we are calling is correct. So it is slash send message, so which means it is correct. And now what we are saying is, if you receive hi, if you basically see hi here in the text, in that case what you should do is, you should send a message, and that message should contain hello. So I'm gonna say hello here, and everything else looks completely okay. So now the code is going to begin from here, read message, and then it is going to go inside this function, read message function, and then it is going to see whether all the messages which we have got, any of the message contains hi. If it contains, then it is going to call send message function. So our code is going to execute from here, and then it is going to send hello. So let's execute it and see if it works as expected. So here you can see in our message we already have hi one time, so we should be able to receive hello one time. So now here you can see we already got hello here. So that's all in this lesson. See you again in the next lesson. Hey everyone, I hope you all are doing good and you're enjoying learning Telegram bots. And in previous session we have learned how we can reply to any messages which is being sent on Telegram group. And in this lesson we are going to learn how we can keep on reading unique messages and keep on replying, because in previous lesson whatever you saw, the problem with this is that if you see in the offset, we have kept offset as static. So it is going to read new message one time, and then it is just going to keep on reading the same message again and again if you keep running the same code again and again. Now to overcome this, I have written a new code, and it is actually, if you see, this code is quite similar to what we had in the previous code. I'll let you know what is the changes which we have made. So now in this code, new code, what I have done is here you can see that our function is now accepting offset, okay, which is basically a parameter, and this parameter we are updating here. So this function is now returning offset and also accepting offset. And now here this is a place where we were calling this function. Okay, and now you can see in this function what we are doing is read message is the function which we were calling, and now we are passing offset value to this function. And initially when we are calling it for the first time, in that case offset is going to be 0, and then it is going to read the message, and then whichever is the latest offset, basically latest update ID, that latest update ID is going to get assigned to offset. And then this function is going to be called again with the new offset or latest offset. Okay, because here we are saying while is true. Okay, this is a way to run endless loop. Okay, so this loop is going to keep on running forever, and that is the reason if I run this code now, this code is going to keep on running forever. And I'm just going to run it and going to show it to you. So now you can see this code is running forever, and if it is running, and it is now see trying to pull new messages. So right now there is no new messages, so it is not showing anything here. So here what I will do is I'm gonna write hi. And now you can see once I write hi, we also get reply hello, because that is what we have written in our code. And also it prints out the same message here in the backend. But now if you see, if I write something else, for example, let's say if I write a test or some message, in this case, you can see that we are not getting any reply. Okay, we just, but here in the backend, you can see that our new message is being read. So new message is being read by this code, but it is going to just match everything with the message. For example, here we want to match everything with hi message, and if it is matches, then we want to send the reply. Okay, so this is what this code can do. So here if I write hi again, it can reply hello again. So it doesn't matter how many times I write hi, it will keep on replying hello. And it is not going to read the same message again. So for example, let's say if I stop this code, and if I run this code again, in that case it is not going to reply with hello. Okay, so I'll just show it to you here. You can see the screen here on the right side. And now let's say if I run this message again, it is not going to reply hello, because it has already processed this message. Okay, these are older messages, so that is the reason. Now it knows it has already processed older messages, it is not going to process the same message again. And that is how you make sure that you always process unique message again, and you always make sure that all your latest messages are being processed. So that's it in this lesson. See you again in the next lesson. Hey everyone, I hope all of you are doing great. So this is a new lesson, and in this lesson we are going to learn about chatbots. So until now we have already learned how to send messages, how to receive a message, or how to reply to any message. So now we are going to talk about what is the functionality of a chatbot. So typically chatbot also receives some input, and then it sees whether it has answer for that input, and then if answers are available, it is going to reply with that answer. Okay, so that is what a typical functionality of a chatbot going to be. So it looks more like a question and answers, right? So you have set of questions which is coming from users, and you see whether you have any matching answer for this question. And if you have the matching answer, you want to reply with that answer. And if there is no answer available, you may want to reply that, sorry, I couldn't understand you, something like that. Okay, so for this, basically what we need is we need set of questions and we need set of answers. So if you go to GitHub, you can see I have uploaded this data, which contains four columns: question, answer, source, and metadata. Now, source and metadata, these are two columns which you don't need for now, and just question and answer is enough. So basically, we need to have a file, a CSV file or any file, which should have a question, set of all the questions and set of all the answers. So for example, here you can see there is a question which is called, do you ever get hurt? And the answer for that is, I don't have a body. Now this file which I have is actually a tab delimited file. Okay, so it is tab separated file. If you have a comma separated file, that is fine as well, but just make sure your whatever data you have doesn't contain comma. And also, I'm going to give you the link of this file. So if you want to use this file and test it and want to see how it looks like, then you can do that. This file right now has 10,000 questions and answer. I have customized some of the questions and answer. And in the answers, I have put the answers which I think will be more relevant to my use case. However, in your use case, you may want to update this file with some questions and answers which you think will be relevant in your user group or your Telegram group. Okay, for example, let's say if your business is or your Telegram group is talking about music, then you know there is a lot of question going to come about music, and you want to put all those questions and answer in this file, and then you want to create the chatbot. Okay, so this is the code which actually we are going to run, and I just want to cut this code from here, and I want to run this code separately here. So first I can show you how exactly we can read a file from we can read the data from any tab separated file. So here you can see in URL, this is the URL which I have given, and this URL is actually this URL which I just copied and I pasted here. And then we are using Pandas data frame. So if you know about Pandas data frame, it's going to be excellent. It's very easy for you to understand. And if you are someone who don't know about data frame, so data frame is basically a simple way of handling a structured data, okay, a data which is having a number of rows or number of columns. So this is how you read the data. So here you are saying you are creating a data frame variable, and you are saying pd.read_csv and URL. So this is a URL basically which we are giving here. And in separator, we are saying it is a tab delimited separator. So that's why we have written slash t. Now, what I can do is I can do df.head 5, and it is going to print only 5 records from this complete file. So you can see in this file, we have 10,000 records or 10,000 rows. Now I'm going to execute it, and let's see how we see the output here. We see very clean output. We can see in question, we have all the questions. In answer column, we have all the answer. In source, we have all the source. And in metadata, we have all the metadata. And similarly, if you want to see more number of columns, for example, if you want to see 50 records, then you can just replace it to 50. And now you can see you are able to see more number of records here. Okay, so this is how this works. And this is how you read the read any file's data into data frame. So now I'm going to cut it and going to put it back in this code. Okay, so I'm going to explain this code to you. It is very similar to our previous example. So until here, what we are doing is we are just declaring a file, a data frame. Okay, and in data frame, we are going to have all the content. Okay, and this base URL is again a Telegram's URL, which is going to remain the same. And now if you see in read message, we have not made any changes. Read message is exactly the same function which we have already written. And in send message, again, there is slight change which I have made. I'm going to explain it to you in a moment. And now what we need to do is I'm going to create one more function, and that function is going to be called auto answer. I already have that function here, so I'm going to paste that function here, and I'm going to explain it to you what exactly it is doing. So what auto answer will do is it is going to receive one message. Okay, so basically if any Telegram user, so for example, let's say a Telegram user is sending hi or who created you or any such message. So that message is going, we are going to pass to this function, auto answer function, and then this method is going to compare that whatever that message has come, it is going to compare that message with the questions which is available here. Okay, so it is going to compare that with the question, and if it matches, then it is going to give that answer and going to keep that answer in answer variable. Now there can be two possibilities: either there will be answer available or there will not be answer available. Okay, so if the answer is available, then we are going to return whatever the actual answer is, we are going to return that answer. Okay, so that is why we have put this in if condition. So if we are saying if answer is not empty, which means if answer is available, then return the answer. If answer is not available, in that case, just return this message. And this message is going to be returned from, you know, any place where we are calling this function. Okay, so I'm going to call this function here in read messages. If you see in read messages, earlier we had a for loop, and inside for loop we were doing a comparison of high and then we were calling send message. Now we don't need to do this comparison, so I'm going to remove this, you know, high check which we were doing in if statement. And rather than, we are just having a for loop, and inside this we are calling send message. Okay, send message function, and we are passing the message which we have received. So now this send message function is actually this function, send message function, which receives a message, and then what it does is it calls auto answer function. Okay, so it goes and finds out if we have any answer available or not, and if the answer is available, in that case it is going to assign that answer to this answer variable which we have which we assign to a key value pair. Okay, so this is how this function has been now updated, and we haven't really made any other changes apart from this. And now if I ask any question which is available in the list of these questions, then it should be able to auto reply. So I'm going to run this, and hopefully if everything is okay, it should be running fine. Okay, so we can see it has started to execute, and right now it is not showing any message because it doesn't have any new message. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to write hi and hit enter. Now we can see right now it is saying, sorry, I couldn't understand you. I'm still learning and trying to get better in answering. Okay, so probably for this answer is not available. Let's try to ask something else and see if we get the answer. So for example, I'm just going to copy one of the questions from here and going to ask the same question, and let's see if it is able to answer. Unfortunately, it seems that it is not able to answer at the moment. Okay, so there seems to be something wrong. Let me just have a quick check. Okay, so I think here this is supposed to be a function, and I had not put parentheses here. So now I have put parentheses, and this time it should be okay. So I'm just going to execute it again, and let's go ahead and type hi again and see if we receive the answer this time. Okay, so this time we can see we have received hello from this chatbot. And again, I'm going to ask some different questions. So let's ask, do you sweat? And I'm not able to copy, so I'll just type it here. Let me type, do you sweat? And it is saying I don't have a body. Okay, which means basically it is able to reply from this list of these questions. So for example, okay, here you can see I had asked it some questions related to, you know, who created you and so on. So for example, I'm just going to write this question, who created you, and it should be able to reply. So here you can see it is replying, Vikasja has created me, and it is telling my YouTube ID or whatever. Okay, so here you can see these are the question and these are the answer which has been written. So it is checking all this question, and then it is replying with the matching answer. Okay, and if any of the question is not available, then it is simply saying that right now, sorry, I couldn't understand you, something like that. Okay, so here I'm just gonna write something, some gibberish, hit enter, and you can see that it is saying that it is not available. But as soon as I write something which is available, like I write hi, I get the reply hello. If I write hello, I get reply hello. If I write okay, let's see if I get anything. Okay, I get that's great. Okay, so this is how actually you can create a chatbot. So in your group, if anyone is going to ask any question, in that case, this chatbot is going to immediately respond if it finds a matching question. Okay, so I hope the session was useful, and if you have any query, do let me know. So that's all in this session. See you again in the next lesson. Hey everyone, I hope all of you are doing great and you have been learning creating Telegram bot and really enjoying this. So in this session, I'm going to show you how to reply to a specific message. So in Telegram, we have an option of replying, and then if you, for example, let's say this is the message which you have, and if I click on reply, I can reply to this particular message, okay? And you will also see original message in the when someone is replying, okay? So this means you are replying particular, you are replying to a particular message, and this is actually a great way of replying when you are using bot automation or chatbot, because this is going to make sure that your bot is always replying to a specific message and there is not going to be any confusion. For example, let's say when you have a big group, you may be seeing that, you know, hundreds of users replying or hundreds of users writing hi to you in a group. Now, if your bot is replying, your bot needs to know, or people at least needs to know, which message has been replied to. Okay, so that is the reason we are going to learn how we can reply to a specific message. So first of all, I'm just going to run this code for a moment so we can just quickly see what is the message which we are receiving. So I'm just going to write hi, and we have received hello, which is fine. So code is working. Now I'm just going to scroll little down, and now here you can see this is the message which we have. Okay, so now notice one thing: under the messages, under message key value pair, we have something which is called message ID. Okay, so message ID is always unique to one particular group. So in this group, or this group which we have created, this message ID is assigned to this message. Okay, this message, and this is always going to be unique. So if I send new message, it is not going to assign the same message ID again to this message. Okay, so that is how you make sure that it is always a unique message which has been sent here. And when you want to reply to that unique message, there is a way to do that. So for that, what we need to do is, in the send messages, we are going to include reply to message ID. Okay, so I'm going to use a comma here. And now here in reply to message ID, we need to provide the message ID to which we want to reply. So now if you notice one thing, in this function, we are only receiving message, okay, which is actually the text part of the message. So now what I'm going to change it from the text part, rather than the text part, I'm going to change it to the complete message string. Okay, so let me change it a bit, and what I'm gonna do is, I'm going to here you see we have result messages. So rather than this, I'm just going to remove message text part. So let us pass result, which is going to be complete key value pair, to here, and then we are going to say text equal to, and now under message we have message text, which is going to be our text message which has been sent, and message ID is going to be, under message we are going to have message ID. Okay, so this is fine. Now I can say reply to message is equal to message ID. Okay, so many a times I'm saying equal to, but that's not what I really mean. So when we are saying message, when I'm saying reply to message ID, so this is a key and this is a value. Message ID is the value for this key. Okay, so because this is a JSON, or this is a dictionary, and dictionary always have key value pair. So this looks quite okay, and I hope it is going to work. So let's run it, and let's see if it works or we get any error. So I'm going to write hi, and this time, okay, so we have received some error. So just give me a moment, I'm going to check why we are getting this error. Okay, so it is going to be message, and then inside message it is going to be message ID. So my mistake there, and I'm just going to run it again, and this time again I'm going to write hi, and now seems there is couple of errors which has occurred here, so that we need to fix. Here you can see, now in answer earlier we were passing text, so now it is message, so I need to fix it as well. So this is going to be text, so this is going to be actually text. Okay, and everything else looks okay. Now let's run it, and now we can say hi. Okay, so we have already actually received reply for hi. So I'm just going to write something else. I'm just gonna say hello, and you can see now we are getting this reply, and this is actually sent as a reply to this message. Okay, if I ask something else, like who created you, and you can see it is answering and actually replying to this particular message. Okay, so now this is making a lot of sense, because now when a lot of people or a lot of users in this group is going to ask questions, this bot is always going to make sure it is replying to that particular or that unique, you know, message. So that's it in this lesson. See you again in the next lesson.